shit, sorry.
I don't care.
Man, oh, you.
I can buy the etheric light, I just don't see any point in buying it.
No.
Yes, there is rest for the wicked!
Two for one.
Yeah. All four of us are going to need to be his man, though.
If all four of us are on the other team, he probably won't be able to get his ult in the game. And all we gotta do to prevent him from killing his ult is two people can't near his ult. So he has to kill us
still
to get to the ult.
Still think you owe me an apology.
That's what we need to start doing. You guys will buy. Is he still boosting on his ult? That's the only reason he gets a lot of kills. It's all the kills off his ult. He averages like 15 kills off his ult a game. So, subtract however many deaths that he has and how many kills he goes at. That's what I always do. Subtract the kills from his ult. That's how many kills he has. Yep, there you go. Gonna end up with a 15 or more kills on his ult. Yep. So he didn't really have that many kills. He has to have an ult to boost his ego. That's exactly what he does. He has an ult to boost his ego. You think this guy's so great because he gets all these kills when his ult is the only reason he gets any kills. He needs to lead with his ult and near the end of the game so people can't just sit there and look at, wow, look how pathetic he is. If I was boosting on an ult, I would make that thing leave like near when the match is over. I wouldn't like keep that ult in there. That just proves how much of a loser you are. Just let that ult sit there. BTRD. I like how I sent hate mail to Bioshock Dragon. He didn't even respond to me. There's nothing that guy can say to me either. So I sent a message saying, tell, teabagging him for 10 seconds at a time. He didn't even respond. Yeah, what are you gonna say to that? I'm not kidding. Darth Bondzo had to watch me teabag him for a total of a minute straight. A minute. Because I killed him 6 times and I teabagged. I died twice teabagging him too. I sat there and teabagged as Bioshock Dragon.
Fireball! We can't stop it now!
Completely teabagging the top of his head, meleeing his body. Over and over and over. Teabag, spamming nades at his body as I'm walking over to go to. I would box spam, and I would spam all my nades at his dead body, then I would start teabagging him, and pummeling his body. I think he's gonna say, he's gonna make up some bullshit like
yes, there is rest for the wicked!
I beat that dude in a fucking 1v1 by 5 kills on the neutral host. I got nothing.
This guy just wants me!
That's not good. That's good. That's good. He thinks he's like the best Bioshock player. He's not anywhere near the best. His ult, though. No one is. I've never heard a single person ever admit that he's the best player except for Bioshock Dragon and himself. Those are the only people that will tell you he's the best Bioshock player. It's kind of hard to sit there. I know Frank Fontaine was the best for a while. I don't know about before then. I don't know. It's kind of hard to say. If he played, I would love for Graeme to play in the old days. He would get destroyed if he played against the old days. Back when nobody was box spamming, when everyone played this game, and there was no noobs around, he was crazy. He wouldn't have been able to get a kill. He wouldn't have won a single survival. He wouldn't even gone into survival. Frank would have completely raped him in survival. That guy got killed so quick in survival. It's like you never saw him the whole game. He got hosed every single game. He won every single game. He was the most frustrating person to go against in Survivor, right? He won almost every Survivor game. It was like a ghost. It was like playing against a ghost. I think Gunner is one. I never fought for him. He never wanted to fight me. Bioshock Dragon. Yeah.